जय श्री माता जी। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। वेलकम टू द 9th डे ऑफ द नवरात्रि। लेट्स ऑल गो डाउन टू श्री माता जी, रीज आवर मदर कुंडलिनी एंड पुट बंधन। विल टेक श्री गणेश मंत्र। श्री माता जी, यू आर श्री गणेशा मदर, काइंडली एस्टैब्लिश ऑल द क्वालिटीज ऑफ श्री गणेशा विद इन अस। Mother, kindly establish the purity and chastity within us. Shri Mataji, kindly make us your beloved son Shri Ganesha. On this 9th day of Navratri, we'll recite Sri Mahalakshmi Ashtakam.
नमस्तेस्तु महामाये श्रीपीठे सुरपूजिते शंखचक्रगदाहस्ते महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। नमस्ते गरुडारूढे कोलासुरभयंकरी सर्वपापहरे देवी महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। सर्वज्ञे सर्ववरदे सर्वदुष्टभयंकरी सर्वदुःखहरे देवी महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। सिद्धि बुद्धि प्रदे देवी भुक्ति मुक्ति प्रदायिनी मंत्रमूर्ते सदा देवी महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। आद्यंतरहिते देवी आद्यशक्ति महेश्वरी योगजे योगसंभूते महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। स्थूल सूक्ष्म महारौद्रे महाशक्ति महोदरे महापापहरे देवी महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। पद्मासनस्थिते देवी परब्रह्मस्वरूपिणी परमेशि जगन्मातर महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। श्वेतांबरधरे देवी नानालंकार भूषिते जगत्स्थिते जगन्मातर महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते। महालक्ष्म्यष्टकं स्तोत्रं यः पठेद् भक्तिमान् नरः सर्वसिद्धिमवाप्नोति राज्यं प्राप्नोति सर्वदा। एककालं पठेन्नित्यं महापापविनाशनं द्विकालं यः पठेन्नित्यं धनधान्यसमन्वितः त्रिकालं यः पठेन्नित्यं महाशत्रुविनाशनं महालक्ष्मीर्भवेन्नित्यं प्रसन्ना वरदा शुभा। साक्षात् श्री आदिशक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देव्यै नमो नमः।
Let's bring our right hand on our Sahasrara. Shri Mataji, we thank you very much for the self-realization. Mother, thank you very much for making us understand how great we are. Mother, thank you very much for bringing all the blessings of the divine. Mother, we thank you very much for raising us higher and much higher from where we were. Mother, we thank you very much for sustaining us and helping us to improve and correct ourselves. Mother, we thank you very much that you came on this earth, taken your birth, and worked so hard for all of us. We'll bring our right hand back on the lap. In this meditative state, we will now hear Sri Mataji's speech.
Today is a special day, as you know. We are worshipping the goddess who came on this earth 9 times before to kill all the demons and all the negativity and relieve all the bhaktas to worship. All her work is already being described. Despite that, we find new type of devils, new type of negative people have come back. Perhaps it had to be. This had to be, maybe after all is Kali Yuga, and the drama of Kali Yuga would not be performed unless and until they are there. So to complete this drama, they came. But this time is going to be a very different type of war. It's going to be the war of the peaceful people. And the peaceful people are the most successful people in every walk of life, even in the world. It did not work out before. They say that when Genghis Khan came, he went to a very big monastery of Buddhist near Gaya and killed all of them. There were about 30,000 of Buddhists there. And they didn't say a word and they were all killed. So people started disbelieving in Buddhism. They said, what kind of a Buddhism is here? Why didn't Buddha save them? That's human style of thinking. Buddha should have saved these 30,000 people who were peaceful, who were resisting in a manner that was no resistance. And so they were all killed by this horrible fellow called Genghis Khan. But you'll be surprised, in this Kali Yuga, this Genghis Khan has been praised by many authors. There are books written about him. He was not a Muslim, but some sort of a crackpot. He finished off many mosques, he destroyed many beautiful buildings, and also he came to India and ruled there for a short time. All that's a history. In the same way, there have been wars, between Christians and non-Christians, between Muslims and non-Muslims. All kinds of wars we have heard of, where only the faithful got lost. The real people got lost. The one who worshipped God with full faith got lost. So many people become atheist. And they said there is nothing like God, nothing like His divine power. Never existed. We were stupid, we were foolish to follow all this. And those who were in charge of religion took full advantage of that and said that these people were sinful people. These people were not godly people. And that's how they were killed by us, and we were victorious. The idea of victory they had, that they have been successful, and so many people have been butchered by us. So we come to Kali Yuga. And in Kali Yuga, same thing has started. In a subtler way, in a different way, it has started. That there's a big war going on between the people who are anti-God and who are using God for their own purpose. Very dishonest, very corrupt, very cruel people. And they are using the flag of God, that banner, which they have no right to use. Then there are Sahayogis who have got their realization and they have to fight. Now the difference in the previous wars and this war is very different. In those wars, see, all those who were supposed to be victorious. This was after all the 9 battles of the Divine Mother. The negativity that came up and which became successful started feeling very confident that we have achieved what we wanted. But in Kali Yuga, in the light of Kali Yuga. All those historical victories are regarded as shameful things, as something very aggressive and nonsensical. This is now being described everywhere. Like the white-skinned people went to America and killed all the rest of them there. Now that is coming into light. All these people who thought themselves to be victorious, their children, their grandchildren, their progeny is ashamed of them, ashamed to call that they were their forefathers. Up till the last war. This awareness which has come is the real victory of modern times, of this Kali Yuga. That everything that was accepted as a part of the game, as the lifestyle, you can call it, is now being challenged in modern times everywhere. Whatever is aggression, whatever is oppression, whatever is cruel, is now punished also. You see, so many war criminals might have escaped, but so many went into trials. Never happened before. Nobody took Genghis Khan to a trial. Now, in a very subtle way, all these aggressive people are getting now afraid that they will be questioned and they may be tortured. It started, I don't know where, but definitely at the beginning of the Kali Yuga. If you remember, in this country was a great aggressive man called Mussolini. And ultimately he was hanged. In Germany there was a very powerful man called Hitler and Himmler and all this. God knows what happened to them. Even the Germans don't want to take his name. They are all ashamed of him. Then we had somebody, say in England, Warren Hastings, who came to India. He was put to jail. This was never done before. If Napoleon aggressed people, he thought he was very victorious, but he could not continue with it. He had to face it. You see, anybody who has been aggressive, who has been dominating, who has been very cruel, demonic, has been taken to task mostly in his lifetime. Now, if not in his lifetime, afterwards he was maligned and he doesn't have a name like a hero or anything. People don't want to erect their statues. So the awareness has come in the mind of the people. Like a person like Stalin, who ruled Russia once upon a time. Today you can't see even one statue of Stalin. These are modern times. See the power of modern times. And that is frightening to those people who think they can get along with whatever they are doing. It is going to be very soon understood by them that they have to stop all this nonsense otherwise they will suffer. It's not those whom they are dominating, but those who are dominating will suffer. They will suffer physically, they will suffer mentally, they will suffer emotionally, and also their fame will be in the mud. So today's victory of the power of the Divine Mother is being one very great work is to expose. And this exposure will be condemning publicly those people who are doing wrong. If you see from that point of view, you will understand how we are victorious now. Many of you felt very sad that I didn't get the award. This award makes no difference to me and to you also, I must tell you, because you have come without I having any award, and many will come without having any award as such. But this time, for the first time, if you notice, the people who got award are condemned. Even now, they are writing against it. Even now, they are criticizing. So those who have been, they thought they were very smart. The smartness is out now. And I don't know how long will it go on. Because even today, if you open a newspaper, you find something about it, that how stupidly they have done it. They can't understand what was the reason they have done it. Not only the people who selected are criticized, but very much more the people who are selected. Now, as being Sahaja Yogis, we have to know what is the difference between the consciousness at that time and awareness at this time. That time it was necessary to kill those demons, finish them, but they are back again on the stage. Now, at this time, when it is Kali Yuga, they are exposed. They are condemned. They are put in the jail. They are now punished publicly. So, the collective awareness has got such a great victory, I think, over these people who so many came, killed and died without getting any punishment out of it, without getting any defamation out of it. Now let us see what is consciousness and what is awareness. It's a subtle subject which I think you all can understand. Consciousness is that when you are made conscious, you become conscious of it. Like I have my hand here, all right? But normally I'm not conscious of it, that I have a hand. If a man is sleeping, he's not conscious that he's sleeping. When you tell me you have a hand, I become conscious. Or something pricks me, then I become conscious. Otherwise, I am unconscious about it. I am absolutely unconscious about my eyes. I am seeing everything. But supposing I become blind, I can't see, then I become conscious of my eyes, that I have got my eyes through which now I cannot see. So once you say there is this hand, the consciousness is there. This we can say is the knowledge about the hand, that you get knowledge about the hand. But once you are not conscious of the hand, that knowledge is disappeared. So, to say there is ignorance or there is knowledge, both things are just the same. You are not conscious of your hand, so you are quite ignorant about it. Now, supposing somebody says, your hands are very beautiful. Somebody remarks like that. Then I become conscious of my hand, which is beautiful. Otherwise, I never knew they were beautiful. So, normally, all human beings live at that level, that somebody has to tell you. Now, somebody said, you are wearing a very nice sari, all right? Then I look at it, yes, it's very nice, I never knew. So, somebody has to tell you, then you become conscious. Otherwise, you are not. So, we all human beings at that level are like that. Now, what is awareness? That's a different thing. That means, if I see somebody is attacking me, I put my hand like this. That means I'm aware I have a hand. I'm not conscious, but I'm aware that I have a hand, I have to use it. Like here in Italy, you go on using your hand all the time like this. That means, you know, you are aware that you have got hands, that you have to use them for expressing something more sort of emphatically. So we are sort of also aware of our body. We are aware of others. We know about others. We know what sort of person another one is. Up till you are self-realized. After self-realization, what happens? It's very interesting. After self-realization, you go beyond both these things. Consciousness and awareness. Because you go beyond thought. You have gone beyond thought means what? Anger, all kinds of ideas, all kinds of aggression, everything is maneuvered or worked through your mind. So if your mind is lost, what will you do? There's no mind anymore. You exist with reality. So there is no mind to communicate. We call it thoughtlessly aware. Means what? We have conquered all our enemies by giving up one enemy, that was our mind. There's no mind to suggest. There's no mind to tell you. So once there is no mind, you are lost. Now it is being said that you ask a question to yourself, who am I? As soon as you ask this question, you become thoughtless, so you get lost. You cannot answer this question. Otherwise you might say, I am a woman, I am this, I am that, I am a bishop, or I am a pope, I am this, I am that. But once you are a realized soul, Who will tell you who you are? Because one which tells you is the mind which doesn't exist. No thought. Means you get dissolved into yourself. This is what is reality. But you are aware also. Now, that's another point. If you ask yourself a question, you are not there. But you are aware. If your navi is catching you, immediately you know, my navi is catching, I have got liver. Don't have to ask questions. Or somebody standing near you, left Swadhisthana, oh my God, this one. If somebody is very angry and hot-tempered, immediately you feel such heat from that person. Say, oh Baba, run away from this man. So this is a new realm you have entered into reality, which you are never aware before.
We'll take the three Mahamantras.
Shri कामिनि मोक्ष प्रदायिनि माताजि श्री निर्मला देवै नमो नमः।
We thank you, Shri Mataji, for this beautiful collective morning meditation. Let's all bow down to Shri Mataji, raise our Mother Kundalini and put Bandhan. We'll join together in the evening for the collective evening meditation at around 7:30 p.m. Singapore time. Wishing everyone a very happy Navratri. Jai Shri Mataji. Thank you.
Thank you.